My grandfather was drafted into the Tsar's army. He was actually from Lithuania. His family came from around Riga. It was a terrible thing to be drafted, because if you had money, you bought your son off, or you poked his eardrum or cut off a finger or something to get him out. And someone who was in, it was almost like a shame for the family, because you're inducted for 25 years, can't keep kosher, and the expectation from the Tsar is that that would keep people from being Jewish. So early on, he was in the Cossacks. He was not a Cossack. He took care of horses. He was, you know, like a stableman. And all of his life, he had a terrible cough, which he attributed to having to sleep in stables that were damp and watery. But he was on leave. He was a dashing man, red hair and a mustache, and met my grandmother through friends. She was visiting, and they fell in love and decided to get married. And he ran away from the army. They got married, and he immediately had to leave for America. Couldn't take a chance on getting caught. There was a whole business in ships leaving from Hamburg to America. So he had to get from Riga to Hamburg. And you had to take everything with you. So you took a peckle, everything wrapped up in a blanket, your food, salami, cheese, whatever you had that was going to last you on steerage as you went across. Crossing the river from Lithuania into Germany to get to Hamburg, he lost his peckle and everything he had. And he was in despair, but there were two women, young women, attractive young women from the village who said, "Don't worry, Sam, we'll help you. We'll share our stuff with you." And so they did, going across. Now, of course, the world being small, word gets back that he was seen in the company of two beautiful young women. He goes to Chicago to live with my Uncle Dave. Dave was in the junk business. That was the family business. My grandfather was not a writer. He hated to write letters. He never wrote letters to anybody. So here he is, leaving his bride behind, being seen with two young women, and now he's in Chicago staying with my Uncle Dave and Aunt Nechi. They were at a theater, and there was a fire, and he was seen carrying out this beautiful young woman, who was my Aunt Nechi. But the story goes that word gets back to my grandmother, and she's married to a philanderer, and she still doesn't hear from him. And finally, a letter comes, delivered by the postman. It had to be signed, that it was a big, thick envelope. And she is assuming it's a divorce. And since in Jewish law, if the woman accepts the divorce, it's final. And she was thinking about whether she should actually sign to receive this package, and decided, what the hell, if this is the kind of man he is, I don't want to be married to him. And of course, that was her ticket to America.